Hello, everyone. This is Meina, your crypto friend. Today, I'll be talking about the new Solana mobile Saga. On June 23rd, during an NFT NYC event, Solana officially announced that it is developing its own Web3 Android phone named Saga, made in collaboration with Awesome. It will cost $1,000 at launch and is currently open for a $100 initial refundable deposit for pre-ordering. The actual phone will be available in early 2023. Right now, the only currency accepted is USDC. Based on the Solana Mobile's official website, Saga will only be available in the US, CA, EU, and UK to start. I also checked the current pre-order volume of Saga when I was filming this video. Based on the Doom Analytics dashboard, there were a total of 1,637 pre-order deposits occurred since the announcement. So, what is so special about Saga? Solana claims that there are three key technologies for Saga. Number one, key custody solution, the seed vault. Number two, mobile wallet adapter. Number three, Solana Pay for Android. The seed vault is very easy to understand. They just integrate the phone with a hardware wallet, what they call a specialized hardware to protect Seed Vault from malicious software while handling transactions. The mobile wallet adapter is an open source protocol that connects wallets with dApps on a mobile. They are also creating the Solana dApp store along with the launch of the Solana mobile stack. The third technology, Solana Pay, is just similar to Apple Pay, allowing users to make transactions more smoothly, tap to pay and QR scanning. Soon after the launch, a lot of discussions has been ongoing for Saga. People are claiming that Solana is posing a large and growing threat to Ethereum. For example, Twitter user Nathan.eth has listed several reasons why Solana has better grasped the user needs and appealed to the normal users, while ETH developers are too technical to cater to average users' true needs. Of course, Web3 projects should always keep ease of usage and user experience in mind, because that is what will attract more users. However, I certainly do not see this being a sufficient reason why Solana has been doing more innovations than ETH. Companies or projects have different long-term visions and goals, so are their approaches to achieve those goals. It is fair to say that ETH developers are more focused on fundamental technical improvements to achieve decentralization, while Solana developers put a lot of efforts into the user experience to attract mass user adoption. Maybe most of the average users do not care enough about decentralization right now. Does that mean we should just cater to their preference and continue building on centralization? Then, why are we even having the Web3 innovations in the first place? Maybe some of the ETH developers are longing for a decentralized utopia, but what is wrong with that? Decentralization or centralization is a spectrum right now, not black and white. I will keep an open mind for all of the ongoing discussions. I will also continue to watch how much traction the Solana phone as well as its Solana mobile stack will get in the future. That is all I wanted to share today. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.